So in the case of Ngayoaki Hirakawa, represented by Erika M. Shibamura versus Lobscom Realty Corporation in Attorney Gary M. Chongko, GR number 213230. The facts of the case. On March 22, 2010, Hirakawa filed a complaint alleging that on December 28, 1995, Takeso Sakai, acting for and on behalf of the stockholders and members of the board of directors of several corporations, sold to Lobscom, represented by Chongko, a 92-hectare subdivision project known as Windfield Subdivision in Consolacion, Cebu City, for 100 million pesos. As payment, Chongko delivered 9 post-dated personal checks from Westmont Bank to Sakai. On September 30, 1996, Sakai assigned, transferred, and conveyed to Hirakawa all his rights and interests in 4 out of 9 post-dated checks, totaling 65 million pesos, which represented Sakai's share in the sale proceeds. Lobscom and Chongko were informed of the assignment and agreed to be bound by it. Upon encashment of the first check, Hirakawa requested that the remaining post-dated checks be replaced with new ones in his name. Respondents complied and issued new post-dated checks from PDCP Development Bank, all payable to Hirakawa drawn against Chongko's personal account. When the first PDCP check became due on October 30, 1997, Chongko requested more time to pay the obligation and offered 18% interest per annum for the overdue account, which Hirakawa accepted. However, the subsequent checks due on October 30, 1998 and October 30, 1999 were dishonored because Chongko's account was closed. On February 9, 1999, respondents proposed to assign their shares in a gold court project to Hirakawa as full payment of the 40 million outstanding obligation. Hirakawa agreed and a deed of assignment was executed. However, by 2002, Hirakawa discovered that the gold course was never developed and no stock certificates were issued in his name. He demanded payment from Chongko, who issued 2 post-dated checks from PNB, each for 20 million pesos payable in 2004 and 2005. When the first PNB check became due in 2004, Chongko pleaded for a 1-year extension with 18% interest per annum, to which Hirakawa agreed. However, both checks remain unfunded even after the extension period. On March 22, 2010, Hirakawa served respondent a final notice of demand for payment amounting to 60 million pesos. Respondent's total payment over 13 years was only 28 million pesos, leaving an outstanding debt of 114,027,812.22 pesos, including interest. The issue in this case is whether the Court of Appeals gravely erred in dismissing the complaint below due to Hirakawa's lack of cause of action against respondents. The ruling of the court, the Supreme Court grants the petition, reverses and set aside the decision dated November 19, 2013, resolution dated July 8, 2014 of the Court of Appeals, and remands the case to the Regional Trial Court branch in Pasig City for resolution on the merits with utmost dispatch. The legal basis and explanation of the Supreme Court. Article 1311 of the Civil Code, relativity of contracts. Contracts take effect only between the parties. There are signs and heirs, except in cases where the rights and obligations arising from the contract are not transmissible by their nature or by stipulation or by provision of law. Explanation of the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court agrees with the Court of Appeals that Hirakawa is not a party to the deed of sale dated December 28, 1995. Under the civil law principle of relativity of contracts, contracts can only bind the parties who entered into it and cannot favor or prejudice a third person. What Sakai assigned to Hirakawa were his rights and interests over the 4 post-dated checks, not his interest in the deed of sale. In terms of the body of the complaint determines the nature of the action. The explanation of the Supreme Court, the court noted that Hirakawa's complaint was not solely for breach of contract, but also for damages arising from respondents' alleged fraud, issuance of worthless checks, and other deceits. The trial court denied the motion to dismiss on the ground that the complaint sought more than just a breach of contract, but included claims for damages. In terms of the nature of the cause of action, in the spouses, Paris versus Remarkable Laundry and Dry Cleaning, breach of contract may give rise to an action for a specific performance or rescission of contract. It may also be the cause of action in a complaint for damages filed pursuant to Article 1170 of the Civil Code. Explanation of the Supreme Court. In Hirakawa's complaint, although denominated as breach of contract, ultimately sought the payment of the value of the checks assigned to him, accrued interest, and damages suffered due to respondents' failure to fund the checks. The court clarified that the case is a simple collection suit. In terms of the rules of procedure, should promote substantial justice. Time and again, the court has relaxed the observance of procedural rules to advance substantial justice to relieve a party of an injustice not commensurate with the degree of non-compliance with the process required. Explanation. The court emphasized the procedural rules should not be applied in a very technical sense when it defeats the purpose for which they were enacted. In this case, Hirakawa had waited 14 years for the full payment of Lobscom and Chongco's obligation. Dismissing the complaint now would be unjust for Hirakawa, and the suggestion to file a separate action for collection of a sum of money would only add insult to injury. In terms of the case remanded for resolution on the merits, the court found that Hirakawa had sufficiently alleged causes of action for the collection of a sum of money and damages. Therefore, the case should be remanded to the trial court for determination on the merits of Hirakawa's claim.